own or have any copyrights to any song that is playing in these videos. Hello everybody and welcome to my kitchen. In this video, I have my helper, my son, Sebastian. Say hi.
Hi.
So it is Veterans Day. There's no school today. He is going to be helping me out a little bit with my ingredients and stuff like that. So I just wanted to show off my baby. And so these pretzel buns, they are pretty soft. I always like to make buns for my burgers, chicken sandwiches, whatever. I like them homemade. So anyways, we're gonna get started, but before that, I'm going to show you my apron that I got at the 99 cent store. Look at that, isn't it cute? I love it, and I only paid $1.99 for it, of course. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, so this is our ingredients right here. First of all, we're gonna need 1.5 cups of water, which I have here. And this needs to be warmed to 110 to 115 degrees. If not, your yeast is not gonna activate. Also, you have to make sure that your yeast is good because then it won't activate either. We need 1 tablespoon of honey. We're gonna need 2 1/4 teaspoon of the active dry yeast. We need 4 to 5 cups of flour, and it has to be bread flour. You may need less, so what I recommend is just when you're tossing it in, just toss it in a cup at a time because you don't want the dough to be too dry. And then you're gonna need 1/4 cup of butter, unsalted butter. This has to be melted, so I gotta melt that. We're gonna need 2 teaspoons of kosher salt or any salt. And then here we need 2/3 cup of baking soda. Yeah. I lost my mind on that one. Baking soda, and then we need additional, we're gonna need 10 cups of water. This water is going to be used to dip. So basically the water and the baking soda is gonna be mixed in together on the stove, and then we're gonna mix in our bread in there. So we're gonna get started and we're gonna add everything here to our stand mixer. Okay, so what we wanna do in the bowl of a stand mixer, you're gonna wanna throw your water. So I just warmed this up right now, so I warmed it up. We're gonna toss it in here along with your honey. Can you get me a spoon, baby?
Okay, a big one or?
Just a little spoon. Yeah, okay, we're gonna get out as much as we can of this. I don't wanna. So what you wanna do is mix it so that it dissolves together. And then we're gonna toss in our yeast. Yes, that's the yeast, good boy. Okay, that's mixed in there. And then you're gonna just sprinkle your yeast in here. We're gonna give it a stir. And we're gonna just let it sit here between, I would say, 10 to 15 minutes. And then we gotta let this pretty much foam up. Okay. So when this has already activated, I'll be back. So it takes about 10 to 15 minutes. Mine took 10. If you can see, I don't know if you can see, but you can see that it's pretty much already foamed. So at this point, we're gonna add our melted butter. Oh, you can give it to me. Melted butter. Thank you. Add your melted butter, add your salt. You can add it in there if you want. Okay, and then we're gonna start adding our flour. Pretty much, I'm gonna be doing a cup at a time. This is one. And then we're gonna use our dough hook. And then we're gonna just start mixing. So once that has been incorporated, then we're gonna toss in our other cup. And then we're gonna incorporate this. We're gonna add another cup. So what you're looking for is exactly this right here. You want the dough to pull away from the sides here. You still have some kind of stick to it, but not too bad. So what you're gonna do, we're gonna take it out of here. And you do want it a little bit on the sticky side, just a little bit, not, if you feel that it's dry, you need to start over because then your bread just is not gonna come out. Okay, so at this point, we wanna just gather the dough together like this. Get all these pieces over here. And lay it there. Let me move this here. So all you're gonna do here, we're pretty much just gonna bring it together a little bit. You don't have to like knead this. It doesn't need kneading. I'm just bringing it together. Just like that. And then you want to form it into a ball. So as you can see, it is smooth and it is not dry. You could see when I poke my finger in there. Okay, I'm gonna move this to the side. What you want to do now, you want to get a bowl. You can use the same bowl that you kneaded this in, but I like to use a clean one all the time. We're gonna put some olive oil in there. Smother it around. And then we're gonna flip that way. And then we're gonna flip it back. So what you want the bottom, when you did the ball, you want the bottom on the bottom here. Okay, and then, because you also want to make sure that there's oil on the top. And now what we're going to do, we're going to cover it with plastic wrap. And just like any other bread, We have to let this rise an hour. I'm here in Phoenix and it is hot outside, so it might not take an hour for me because I'm going to put this outside. So you want it in a warm place. Alrighty, so we will see you back 1 hour. Okay, so now this has more than doubled its size. It took 40 minutes. That's because I had it outside. And this is what you need. That's what you need it to look like. All right. And then you're gonna get your parchment paper. You're gonna get your baking sheet. You're gonna add parchment paper to it, set that aside. And then in a pot, or you can use a Dutch oven. I'm using my Dutch. We're gonna add water. We're gonna add the water. Since I have a small one, I'm going to add 5 cups of water. If you have a large pot, add 10 cups. We're gonna bring this to a boil. And then I'm going to add 1/3 cup of baking soda. We're gonna mix that together. So pretty much what you want is just to mix it together, get that incorporated. Stir it well, and then we're gonna let this come to a boil. And while we're doing that, we're gonna get to doing our buns over here. So you're gonna punch your dough down. And then turn it upside down here. And I'm going to use my scale so I can even out the pieces. This dough makes 10 buns, but I'm gonna do 8. So I should get 4. And they should all measure the same. .32. Okay, so we're probably gonna do 0.32 on each one. .29. Okay, so I just have this tiny piece left, and then let me show you what I'm gonna do with the, so you wanna basically just make a ball. So just go like this. Down here, just go like that. Pinch it from the bottom. And then just put it on your baking sheet. Like that. And that's it, and then just do it with the rest. Continue to do that with the rest of the dough. So now what you're gonna do, you already have them here, so one by one you're going to throw them into here. 45 seconds on each side. Okay, after that 45 seconds you're gonna flip it over and do 45 seconds on the other side. So after that's done, you're going to take it out. We're going to place it back on our sheet. And then you're going to keep doing it with all of them. Now that we've got them out of the water, I'm going to leave them right there, and then we're going to get one yolk, we're gonna get 1 tablespoon of water, we're gonna add that to here, and then we're gonna whisk that together. If you want to, you can add milk instead of the water. We're gonna brush the tops of these rolls. So brush them well. Okay, so once you are done brushing the tops well with this egg wash, after it's brushed, then that's when you add the sesames on top. I'm gonna opt out of doing that on these, and then we need a sharp knife. Okay. So what I'm gonna do here is cut the tops like that in an X. And make sure it is a sharp knife so that it cuts right through that. So do it with all of the buns. Just like that. Okay. After your last one, now we're gonna put these in the oven, and these are gonna bake 15 to 20 minutes until golden brown. So now these are just gonna go in the oven. So I have them in the oven already, but I forgot to mention that halfway through the cooking time, you're gonna wanna maybe at 7 minutes, you're gonna wanna rotate the baking sheet around. So at 7 minutes, I'm gonna do that, and then this should be done in about 15-20 minutes. Okay guys, so after 15 minutes, your rolls are super done. Look at how beautiful those are. Pretzel buns. Ooh, they smell so good. Okay. And then all you have to do now is just put them on. Like you have to let it cool. I took them out and I let them cool. And then they are super soft. If you feel that, look. Like look at that. You can literally put your finger in there. And then just put them on a tray or something. They smell delicious. All right, there you go, your soft pretzel buns. And like I said, we're gonna be making some bacon cheeseburgers, and we are going to be using these. So pretty much they're gonna be called pretzel bacon cheeseburgers. Well, pretzel bun, bacon cheeseburgers, I guess you could call it. Okay, guys, enjoy it. I hope you make this recipe, and if you do, tag me in it and let me know how you did. Ciao.